Today, let's talk about what to the what will give us negative 1, and have these three cases for you. The first one is the base and the exponent are the same, and x right here is the real number. Next, x is the real number for the base, but we have an integer n for the exponent. Lastly, x and y are both real numbers, and you see that this time right here, they don't have to be the same. Okay, start with the first one. X to the x power is equal to negative 1. In fact, I'm not going to show you guys like the steps to work it out, because it seems like because we have x in the exponent, we should take natural log both sides. But if you take natural log of negative 1, you get a complex number. You don't really have to do that. Here though, I'll just tell you, because in order to output a negative 1, the base must be negative 1, okay? Then to some power. So I'll just tell you x is equal to negative 1. This right here is it. It's like just look at it and then you should know the answer. Perhaps I'll check the answer for you though. Because if we have negative 1 raised to the negative 1 power, base and the exponent are the same. This negative means that we bring this down to the bottom. And then we have negative 1 right here and then to the positive 1 power. And of course, that's just negative 1. 1 over negative 1. We get negative 1, so it checks. And that is the only solution. What other candidates can you have? If you have x equal to 1 to a 1, it's positive 1, it's not negative 1. If you try 17 raised to a 17th power, I guarantee you it's not negative 1. Pi to the pi, it's not negative 1, so that's it. Okay, next though, we have more solutions. The base x will still have to be negative 1. But to what power though? Well, here's the key. If we have a negative 1 to an odd integer, then the result will give us negative 1. So I will just say n equals an odd number. And to write an odd number, I'll just put this down as 2k minus 1. And this is a form of an odd number. And right here, I should indicate that k is an integer. So this right here will work. I'll give you an example. Let's say, well, x is negative 1 for the base for sure. And the power right here, let's say, is 17. If you want to get n being 17, then k should be what? Well, leave a comment down below, let me know. But the output is going to give us 17. This means you take negative 1, multiply by negative 1, and then you write down negative 1 17 times. You write down negative 1 17 times, multiply them out. It's an odd, right? A number of negative 1. So you really will end up with negative 1. Let me just write this down. I'm not going to write down 17 negative 1s, but yeah. If you pair two of them up, it's going to be positive, but at the end you have a negative. So just do it and you get negative 1 and then you're done. It works for any odd integer. It can also be a negative 17. It will still work. Right? If you have a negative 17, you just bring that down to a denominator. And it will be similar to this, 1 over negative 1, you still can get negative 1. Now for the last one, x to the y equals negative 1. X and y are real numbers. I know you might want to ask me for the complex numbers, but maybe in the future. Anyways, so for this one, I will tell you the base has to be negative 1. That's the only hope. But now, it's trickier for the y though, because y is a real number. We have seen that, of course, negative 1 works. In fact, all the odd integers work. But can we have more possibilities? Yes. Any rational numbers with odd numerator and odd denominator works. So I will write this down for you guys. Y equals, on the top, I need to be an odd numerator. So I'll put down 2k minus 1. On the bottom, it also has to be odd. Let me write down 2l minus 1. Here, k and l are integers. So I claim that this right here is the solutions for that. And I will give you a quick example. Base is negative 1. All right, so let's say the y ends up to be 17 over 3 or something like that. Okay, so now we have the 3 on the bottom. This thing turns into a cube root. And remember, we're just working with real numbers. So this thing right here, right, let me just use a blue marker, of course. You can first take the cube root of negative 1, like so, okay? And then after that, raise that to the 17th power. Now, the cube root of negative 1 is what? It's negative 1. Why? Because negative 1 times negative 1 times negative 1 gives you negative 1. So this altogether is negative 1 raised to the 17th power. You get, you guessed it, yes, negative 1. All right? Checks. And I'm pretty sure this is it. In fact, if you have an irrational number, in fact, negative 1 to an irrational number, you get a complex number.